Hello, my name is Donaldo, and for part 3 of our parameters and design recommendation series, we'll be going over some layout recommendations for our GaN drivers. This video will cover why layout is important and give you layout recommendations for the power supply, inputs, and outputs. A good layout is essential to getting good performance and reducing parasitics in your design. The recommendations in this presentation will help you get better performance out of your layout. The layout is important to avoid having any parasitic inductances or capacitances. Before I begin, I want to go over some general recommendations, which are to have a minimum of 4 layers in your board, to place the FETs close to the driver, parallel source and return traces for flux cancellation, and to separate the signal traces and power traces. These tips, along with the others in this presentation, will help you reduce the parasitics in your design and help you get the best performance. In this presentation, we will be going over a half-bridge driver layout, since a lot of the recommendations can also be applied to low-side drivers. The first thing I want to mention is that the VDD bypass capacitor should be placed as close as possible to the IC. The same applies if you are using 2 bypass capacitors, where the smaller one should be the closest to the IC, followed by the larger one. The pictures show a good layout on the left versus a bad one on the right. The good layout has the bypass capacitor placed close to the IC, whereas the bad layout shows that the capacitor is quite far from the IC, which can lead to issues in your design. Another consideration for the bias supply to keep in mind is that you should use short and wide traces in the bootstrap circuit path. The path goes from the bypass capacitor up to the bootstrap resistor, bootstrap diode, and bootstrap capacitor. Using short and wide traces will help you minimize parasitic inductances on the VDD trace. You would also want the bootstrap capacitor placed as close as possible to the HV and HS pins. If you are using any components at the inputs, we recommend you place them as close as possible to the gate driver IC. It is also important to keep your placement and traces symmetrical. For the output stage, you would want to minimize high current gate drive loops. Since the outputs carry high current, it is important to minimize the output loop to avoid any parasitics. The loop is shown by the red circle on the picture on the left, and the green boxes highlight some of the parasitics that you can minimize. The black line on the picture on the right shows another view of the gate drive loop. It is also important to note that the driver output ground and power FET source need to be as short as possible. Following these recommendations will help you reduce the parasitics and can improve the performance of your design. We also have schematic reviews made for our GaN drivers that you can look at. In addition to schematic recommendations, they also have layout tips that can help you. You can find them on the specific driver's product page under the design and development section. Here are some of the references that I used if you would like to learn more about anything that I have covered in this video.